Okay, thank you. So, first thing first, whenever you are doing any investments or whenever we are doing any sort of investment from ourselves or our family members, the thing that is required is we should keep a track of all the things. And sometimes generally hota kya hai ki hamare investments sab scattered rehte hain alag alag jagah pe. We put our money, we have our money in the bank, we invest in, we have some FDs, we invest in land also, we buy some stocks, we have investment in mutual funds, we take some insurance policies. And but if someone asks us, what are the investments that you are having? Can you give a list of all the investments that you are having? So maybe the answer is no. We are not ready with the things. When we talk about businesses, we prepare balance sheet for it. We prepare P&L account. We keep a track of all the transactions that are happening because we want to know the profitability. We want to understand how our business is growing. But when it comes to personal finance, we take a back seat. And although we are working hard to earn money, but maybe we're not devoting that much time which is required to keep a track of all the investments. So I hope from today's session, after this session, you'll be able to understand and get an idea about how we can track our investment. And it's not a Herculean task. Aisa lagta hai ki bahut mushkil hai. Lekin ek bar jab hum saath mein baithte hain aur Excel ke saath mein agar aap kaam karte hain, to things become very sorted. Okay. So to start with the first sheet, there are four sheets in this Excel file, which I'll be sharing with you also after the session. And you can keep all the information related to you in this Excel file and save it for yourself. So the first sheet has personal details. So the personal details should have your name, date of birth, time of birth, place of birth, then your profession, then your blood group, then your marital status. So these are the basic details. And let me just fill it also so we can have a live idea about how to go about this sheet. And I'm just putting my data only. See, sometimes some of the things like for policy and all, you require date of birth, you require some time of place, birth also, time, place of birth also. So I've mention everything which you might require at some point of time, and we don't have to refer to anyone or ask anyone, call anyone and ask, "Arey ye kya tha, wo kya tha?" We have all the place at one, all the information at one place. Similarly, you have to mention your spouse details also in this sheet. Then your email ID and your mobile. Similarly, you can also put in your details of your spouse also. So it hardly took 1 or 2 minutes to put in all the details, right? Then this is the basic summary of the details that you have. So whenever you have to refer to your own details, you can, or your spouse can, or anyone else can on your behalf can refer to this. Now the most important sheet which all of us are here is about keeping a track of our finances. The heading which ran for this session was how to organize my finances. Your finances in Excel. And this sheet will help you do that. Okay. So sources of income after tax. सो मंथली इनकम सपोज आई हैव टेकन एन एग्जांपल ऑफ 1 लाख, योर स्पाउस इज ऑल्सो अर्निंग एंड शी इज अर्निंग सपोज लेट्स से 75,000 एंड यू आर हैविंग सम रेंटल इनकम एज वेल. सपोज यू आर अर्निंग 25,000 ऑफ रेंट एवरी मंथ. So I'm taking some dummy figures, and suppose you get a bonus of let's say 20,000 every year, and your pay is expected to increase by 10%. So this is the basic detail that you have put. So in this sheet, there are something which are automated. So you get your monthly inflow. We have taken a total of all this. We have not taken total of bonus because bonus you are not sure of whether you'll get it or what amount you'll get it. So we have not taken that into consideration. If you want, you can just add this also here, but better not to take it. So monthly, we are knowing that every month I'm going to earn, me and my wife are going to earn 2 lakh rupees. Now it is also important to keep a track of where this money is going to or how we are spending this money. So the first important thing is household expenses. So every month you are incurring amount on grocery, your maid, your newspapers, your petrol, conveyance and all these things. So these are, you can categorize these into household expenses. So suppose my household expenses are 50,000. Then my child education, I'm spending sort of around 10,000 per month. Then if I'm having any housing loan or any car loan, then you may be giving some amount as an EMI also every month. So whatever is your EMI, you can put it here. Suppose I am having an EMI of, let's say 15,000 and I'm not having any rental expense. So I'm putting it as zero. So you see that your outflow is 75,000. Okay. And you have other shopping expenses every month apart from housing. You spend online on online and let's say that amount is somewhere between what? Let us take as 35,000. So your income is 2 lakh and you are spending around 1,10,000. So 90,000 is the surplus. It is a hypothetical situation. After COVID, this is a thing which might not seem possible, but for people who save money, it can be. So let me increase some household expenses and let's say my household expenses are 80,000. School fees, okay. EMI, I am paying 25,000. Okay. So in a month, I'm earning 2 lakh. I'm spending 1,50,000 and I have 50,000 surplus income. Okay. So this gives me idea about what is my source of income, me and my wife. What are we spending into and what is the saving that we are doing every month? Then we talk about real estate investments and some mutual fund details. So if you have any properties, then you can put the details of the property here. And let's suppose we have a residential house in our name. You can have a residential property. And when did you purchase it? Suppose you purchased it in the year 2000. So if you don't remember the exact date, you can just put the year. And the cost of purchase, that is at what price you purchase a property. Suppose you purchase a property of 25 lakhs. So you can mention 25 lakhs. And what is the value of the investment? That is your property. Suppose it is 1 crore as of now. So you can put this amount. So suppose if you have any commercial property also in your name, you have your offices. You can also mention that. And the year of purchase. And the value. And what is the current amount? Then if you are having any investment in mutual funds, you can put that. If you're having any investment stock, you can put that. Then in this sheet, we have also shared some liabilities. So when we are talking about financial details, these are the income details, like every month, what I'm earning, what I'm spending, and what is the surplus that आई एम हैविंग विद मी, एंड देन व्हाट आर द रियल एस्टेट एसेट वी हैव, व्हाट इज द म्यूचुअल फंड्स दैट आई हैव, व्हाट आर द स्टॉक्स दैट आई हैव परचेज्ड, एंड इफ देयर इज एनी लोन लायबिलिटी, सपोज यू हैव अ हाउसिंग लोन और अ कार लोन, यू कैन पुट दैट अमाउंट आल्सो हियर. Then the loan start date, when did it start date? Then end date, like for how long you are going to pay that loan. Okay. Then, what is the interest rate that on which you are taking the loan? What is the EMI? What's the outstanding amount? And what is the balance term? So, as you put in the values and you put in the interest rate, suppose you are taking housing loan at 13% rate of interest. And whatever your EMI is, suppose you are paying EMI of 33,000 every month, you can put that amount. And what is the outstanding balance of the loan that you can take from the loan statement? And you can put, suppose, the amount is 45 lakhs, and against this car loan you can put 14, maybe 9%, and maybe 18 lakh, 14,000 is the EMI and 18,000 is your loan value. And balance term is month, how many months the EMI is still payable. So in this first case, we assume the loan to be 20 years. So you can put 240 and maybe 1 year or 2 years has gone. You can put 220 months and here you can put 54 months. Then this is an interesting table. Now, investment option, like investment vehicle where you put your money. So I have listed down all the possible sort of investment which is possible and which people are investing money in. So you can have direct equity, you can have mutual funds, you can have fixed deposit, you can have recurring deposit or SIPs. Then you can have an investment in PPF, PPF contribution every month that you are doing, EPF, EPF per month that you and your employer are investing. Then you can investment in gold also, including your jewelry, cash in and cash at bank, international stocks, or I must add your cryptocurrency, because people are crazy about cryptocurrency these days and they are investing like anything, although it is very risky, but still people are doing it. Chit funds, NPS, Sukanya Samriddhi, if you have a daughter and if you open a Sukanya Samriddhi account in her name. Then LICs and the spouse investment, we have just taken the total. So when you punch in these values and you punch in the current value, this sheet automatically calculates the return. We have put some formulas here and this sheet gives you what is the return that you are earning. If you are earning some negative return also, it gives you the amount in negative. And it calculates the percentage of return that you are earning. That is also being taken care of in this sheet. So you realize that what are the segments where you have put your money and what is it worth today? And this you have to keep on updating every 3 months or 6 months. You should update this sheet so as to see that if you have made any new investment, you can add up the amount and what is the current value. You can do that. Okay. Then we have made a separate sheet for insurance policies because it is seen that many people may have taken some policies, but they do not have a record. They don't know what is the premium, when the premium is due, when the policy will get mature, what amount we will get on policy. So if you put the figures in this sheet, then you have all the information at one place. Ek jagah pe aapko sab cheeze mil jayengi. You don't have to refer to your insurance agent or anyone for any information, but this is a one-time exercise which will take some time. But once you invest that time, योर लाइफ इज इजी, आपको कहीं कुछ ढूंढने की जरूरत नहीं है, सारी चीजें आपके सामने आपको इजीली मिल जाएंगी। सपोज आई पुट माई नेम हियर ओनली, सो द नेम ऑफ द पॉलिसी लेट्स से जीवन आनंद है, ठीक है, एंड द इंश्योर्ड अमाउंट इज 25 लाख, एनुअल प्रीमियम आई एम पेइंग सपोज 60,000, मोर डेज ईयरली, प्रीमियम ड्यू डेट इज 15 जुलाई सपोज ऑफ एवरी मंथ, नॉमिनी इज लाइक ईयर ऑफ परचेज सो 2018 एंड ईयर ऑफ मैच्योरिटी 2040। सो दिस वे यू कैन लिस्ट डाउन ऑल द पॉलिसीज दैट यू हैव। सिमिलरली इफ यू हैव टेकन एनी इंश्योरेंस, हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस ऑल्सो, यू कैन पुट द अमाउंट द पॉलिसीज नेम हियर। What is the sum assured? What is the premium? So when you look at this sheet, you get reminded of when you have to pay the premium and what you get at the end of the year. When the policy is going to mature, you can put the exact date also here. Now again, once you keep a record of this thing, then you have to just keep on adding the different information that you have. You might have any term insurance also. You might add some more policies. You have to keep just updating your sheet. Now, whenever we are doing any investment, we are not relating our investment to a goal. I always suggest that whatever investment we are doing, we should add these investment to a particular goal so that whenever we are finding out the value of the investment, we are not just investing our money like for anything. We have a specific purpose for that we are investing, and then when the purpose is achieved, when I realize my goal, then only I'll take out the money from my investment. Until that goal is reached, I'll keep my investment intact. I'll not touch that investment. So what kind of goals one must have in life, or one generally has? So child education, if you are young, if you're not married, then you can have a different set of goals. I've taken an example of a person who is married and who's having kids. So the first goal of that person is child education. So suppose the current year is 2021 and you are looking for your child education and the child is 7-8 years old. So then in that case, in the next 8 years or 10 years, he'll be graduating or he will be going for his further studies. So you are taking the year of occurrence of that particular goal where you will be requiring a lump sum money. So that particular you should put here. Then years to go. So we have created a formula here where whatever amount you put in the year of occurrence, that gets subtracted from the current year and you get the number of years to go. So you have 11 years to save for the goal that you have set for your child education and the cost in current price. That means in today's term, if I want to spend money on my child education, how much it would be? So it would be, I'm just taking an estimate of 15 lakhs. Suppose I want him to do a CA or an MBA. So that might cost 15 lakhs. Although it is not a fair estimate, it is somewhere around 50 lakhs in today's terms if you want him to pursue a higher education or if he is going abroad and doing his studies. And then you have to take the inflation also into consideration. Now, what is inflation? Inflation means the rise in the prices. So if, for an example, the petrol, which was costing 50 rupees, 3 years back, 4 years back, it is not at the same price. It keeps on increasing and it has crossed 100 mark also. So similarly, the education keeps on increasing and you have to put inflated cost into consideration. You take inflated cost into consideration because the amount will not remain same. So here we have taken an inflation rate of 6%. In case of education, it is almost 10%. So education expense increases by 10%. And normal inflation rate, you can assume to be 7% or so. So this is education inflation rate, 10%. And then if you take up the normal inflation, you can consider it to be 7%. So here we have put the formula of future value, which says that you take the rate of inflation that we are taking 10%, then NPR is the period, the time by which you would require this amount to be calculated for. So we are taking this from this column years to go. Then the PMT. PMT is the monthly payment that you are required to do. So we are not going to do any monthly payment. We are going to require the money in a one go, one lump sum amount that we are looking to get. And then the present value. The present value of the cost that you are pursuing, that you are looking to spend in future. And then type is like you want to spend at the end of the year or the beginning of the year. So we are taking at the beginning of the year. So we have taken the type one at the end of the period or beginning of the period. So you see that if you are assuming 50 lakhs to be spent on your child education today, in today's term, then in 11 years, it will grow to 1,42,65,000. So that means in 11 years, your investment should be such that which will be able to earn, give you a lump sum amount of 1,42,00,000. So if you are investing somewhere 50 lakh rupees in some provident fund, let's say PPF, you have put 50 lakhs rupees in PPF. So PPF is earning 7.1%. So let us calculate what your earnings will be after 11 years. So NPR I'm taking 11, PMT 0, my investment is 50 lakhs and beginning of the year. So my amount, if I invest in PPF, will grow to 1,52,04,260. But my education expense will grow at the rate of 10% and it will be 1,42,00,000. So that means there is a shortfall of 37,41,000. This is the shortfall. So you can, with this help of this sheet, you can track your goals, like how you are investing your money and what will grow in the future. Similarly, in the second goal that you have taken is the purchase of plot or a house. Suppose in 3 years from now, you are looking to purchase any house and property and it is going to cost you, we have a budget of 50 lakhs. So after 3 years, you will not require 50 lakhs, but you will require 61,25,000 to invest in that particular property. Similarly, you have a vacation goal. You're looking for to go out for a foreign vacation in the year 25 and you have 4 years to go. And your current cost of travel is 7,50,000. So if the inflation you assume to be 7%, then your inflated cost of the expense will be 9,83,000. Similarly, if you talk about your child marriage, then you are pursuing that after 20 years, your child will get married and you're going to spend 1 crore on his marriage. Then in 20 years, the cost would be increasing to almost 4 times and it will be 3,86,00,000. We are taking an inflation rate of 7% in all the cases. Then suppose in the year 49, you want to retire and you have 28 years to go. And you are assuming that you will require a corpus of 20 lakhs, 2 crore rupees from now. So that 2 crores will grow to 13 crores, 29 lakhs after 28 years. And emergency fund is something which you should all have. And you are taking emergency fund is calculated by 6 times of your monthly income. So if I'm earning 5 times or 6 times, if you're earning 1 lakh rupees and if you multiply by 6 lakhs, so you should have 6 lakh of emergency fund in liquid fund in your bank account or FD, which you can break and you can take out the money. So that will also grow. That also grows and that becomes 6,42,000. So these are some tools which I am talking about today, which I'm discussing with you so that you can understand how you should manage your finances, how you should do your investment so that you earn the desired rate of return, which will be required to meet the cost of expenses, which are going to be there in the future. So I'll just go through the sheets again, and I'll just give you a summary of what we had seen so far. This is the first, the general information that we have to put, your information, your wife information, your contact details. Then we missed this part, financial dependence. So if you have any son or daughter, you can put their name here. Kushagra city is my son and he's 7 years old and son. If you have any daughter, you can mention the daughter's name and the age. Whosoever is financially dependent on you, you can put in their details. Then we talked about the financial details that you can that you should have, like your monthly income, your spouse monthly income, your rental income, any bonuses that you are assuming, then what increase that you are expecting every year, then household expenses, whatever expenses you are incurring, so it will give you the surplus. So if you see the calculation, inflow minus outflow is your surplus, 50,000. Then whatever real estate investment you have, whatever mutual funds you have taken, whatever stocks you have taken, then your liability. So if you are having any housing loan or any car loan, you can put the details over here in this sheet and you can put the EMIs. Then the most important part of the sheet was the current investments that you are having. So I've listed down the various investment options that you might have, the direct equity, mutual funds, FDs, recurring deposit, PPF, EPF, gold, cash in hand, cash at bank, international stocks or cryptocurrencies, then chit funds, NPS, Sukanya, LIC, and your spouse investments. So the amount invested, the current value, the return in rupees, it will calculate automatically, then the return in percentages. So you can also track that whatever amount you have invested, but whether it is giving that much, that kind of returns or not. So if we talk about PPF and suppose 15 lakh value has grown to, let's suppose, 16,80,000. I change that amount and you see that your return value also changes, your percentage also changes. So you can see if a return is earning, if your investment is earning 8% and your inflation is growing at 10%, then that return, that investment vehicle is not correct, or you should take some action on itself. So this is how you can track your investments at one place. Similarly, I talked about the insurances also. So if you are having any insurance policies, whatever insurance policies you have taken, or your father or mother you have taken, had taken for you when you were minor. So 2-3 points that you should consider in these policies. Whether do you have a nominee or not? Because in the last 2 years, I've seen many cases, the nominee is not updated, the nominee is not mentioned in the policy. And if something happens to the insured, then the LIC or any other insurer company is not able to remit the amount proceeds to the nominee because there is no nominee registered. And in some cases also seen that in X policy, Y was the nominee and they both met with an accident and now X is also not there and Y is not also there. So can anyone tell me what will happen in that particular case? Agar aapke naam pe ek policy hai aur aapne wife ko नॉमिनी किया है और एक एक्सीडेंट में दोनों ही नहीं रहते हैं तो फिर उस पॉलिसी का क्या होता है? एनीवन, यू कैन अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड आंसर. डिपेंडेंट. सो साक्षी, कैन यू इलैबोरेट ऑन दिस डिपेंडेंट?
Sir, the policy amount will go to the dependent, the claim amount.
Who is dependent in that case? Like the child you want to say?
Yes, yes.
Although his name is not there in the nominees list, or he's not mentioned as a nominee, that if there are two dependents, then what will happen?
No, sir.
The insurer will divide the amount in 50-50 to both. Is it like that?
No.
See, I'll share a true incident with you all, that in one of our clients, what happened is the mother and the son, they both had insurance and mother had done nominee of his son in the policy and son has nominated her mother in a policy. And unfortunately, both had got infected by corona, and both of them expired, both died. And now the father is left alone. So do you think, or is it the case that the insurer will pay the amount to the father of the policies of both? Or what will the father have to do to get the full amount from the company, insurance company? Suppose the son is having a term insurance of 50 lakh rupees and the mother is having some other insurance of 10 lakh or whatever amount it may be. So will the amount flow to the father? Anyone? अगर नॉमिनी नहीं रहा तो इंश्योर नॉमिनी है, नॉमिनी नहीं है और इंश्योरेंस की इंश्योरर की डेथ हो जाती है, फिर क्या होता है? क्या वो कंपनी? हाँ यस मैम
सर, अगर कोई विल बनी हुई है तो फिर एलआईसी देगा या इंश्योरेंस देगा, राइट? अदरवाइज कोर्ट से सारा सेटलमेंट होगा.
एग्जैक्टली. सो यस, लीगल हेयर, बलवंत जी ने लिखा है लीगल हेयर. So two three possibilities are there. If there is a will, जैसा कि मैम ने भी बोला है कि अगर will होगी तो will में जो भी mention है legal heir कौन है उसको पैसा मिलेगा. अगर मान लीजिए the insurer had died interstate का मतलब होता है कि बिना will लिखे उसकी death हो गई और nominee भी नहीं रहा, तो फिर क्या होगा? That the case is very difficult. फिर क्या होगा? The person who is surviving or the legal heir, in the legal terms if we talk about, he will have to get a succession certificate from court, and that is a very cumbersome process because he will have to get the NOC from everyone. Har kisi se usko NOC lena padega ke they do not claim any amount from this insurance policy. Aur wo NOC milne ke baad court ek apna order dega aur uske baad insurance company usko paise degi. So these are very small things in life that we miss sometimes. और बाद में हमें पता पड़ता है, जब तक सब कुछ ठीक चल रहा है तो हम ध्यान नहीं देते हैं, बट जैसे ही कुछ गड़बड़ हो जाती है then we realize the implications के इसमें कितना कितना प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है, क्या क्या इश्यूज हो सकते हैं. तो दिस इज फॉर दिस अवेयरनेस ओनली आई हैव प्लान्ड दिस वेबिनार के इट इज अ संडे इवनिंग और क्योंकि पीपल कैन टेक अप टाइम, तो हम लोग थोड़ा सा ध्यान दें इन सब चीजों पे और लेट अस बी अवेयर अबाउट ऑल दिस थिंग्स एंड वी शुड प्लान डू अ प्लानिंग प्रॉपरली वेयर इन यू शुड चेक दैट ऑल द पॉलिसीज दैट यू हैव टेकन हैव अ नॉमिनी, और अगर कोई नॉमिनी नहीं है तो उसको अपडेट कराएं. या अगर आप माइनर थे और आपके पेरेंट्स ने आपके अगेंस्ट में कोई पॉलिसी ली और उसमें वो नॉमिनी है और आप अब आपकी मैरिज हो गई है, तो यू शुड गेट योर नॉमिनी चेंज टू योर वाइफ लाइक दैट. देन again, another important aspect of your investment is that you should always link your investment with your goals, because jaisa ki humne suna hai ki a dream without a plan is just a wish. Matlab hum sochte bahut kuch hai, hum ye kar lenge wo kar lenge, lekin agar hamare paas uske liye koi plan nahi hai to jo bhi hum soch rahe ho wo vyarth hai, usse kuch achieve nahi hona. But if you have a plan and if you work on that plan and you can track that plan, then you can understand ki ha maine kya socha tha aur main kahan tak अचीव कर पाए हैं, मुझे कहाँ कितना और डिस्टेंस रह गया, कितना और मुझे आगे जाना है. सो सिमिलरली व्हेनेवर वी आर डूइंग एनी इन्वेस्टमेंट्स वी शुड हैव एन आइडिया अबाउट कि हम किसके लिए इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, क्या गोल है, हम उससे क्या अचीव करना चाह रहे हैं. और जब तक हम उसको अचीव नहीं कर पा रहे हैं तो हमें उस गोल के साथ, गोल को हम चेंज नहीं कर सकते हैं. इफ यू हैव अ किड्स यू कैन नॉट कॉम्पन्स यू विल नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन देयर एजुकेशन. आप उसको कहीं पे भी कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करना चाहिए. अगर उनकी मैरिज करनी है तो आप मैरिज में अच्छे से मैरिज करना चाहेंगे, आप कहीं पे भी कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं करना चाहेंगे. इफ यू वांट टू गो फॉर अ हॉलीडे यू मे पोस्टपोन दैट ट्रिप बट यू विल नेवर कैंसिल इट. ठीक है, तो उन सब चीजों के लिए तैयारी होनी चाहिए हमारे पास. वी शुड हैव एडिक्वेट इंश्योरेंस, वी शुड डू एडिक्वेट इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट वॉट एवर यू आर इन्वेस्टिंग, वॉट एवर यू आर प्लानिंग, यू शुड हैव अ ट्रैक ऑफ ऑल दिस. एंड इन टुडे डिजिटल वर्ल्ड, पहले के लोग होते थे लाइक व्हेन आई सी माय फादर एंड माय ग्रैंडफादर, दे कीप अ ट्रैक ऑफ रिकॉर्ड इन द रजिस्टर्स एंड ऑल पेपर्स वर्क एंड ऑल, दे हैव अ होल बैग ऑफ थिंग्स. ठीक है, फाइल्स होती हैं उनके पास. बट व्हेन वी आर इन द डिजिटल एरा वी शुड यूज टेक द हेल्प ऑफ डिजिटल इक्विपमेंट्स एंड एप्स. बहुत सारे ऐप ऐसे हैं जिसमें आप ट्रैक कर सकते हो, लाइक इंड मनी इज वन ऐप देन वही खाता एक ऐसी चीज होती है जहां पर आप अपने एक्सपेंसेस को रिकॉर्ड कर सकते हो, ठीक है. क्रेड इज एन एप्लीकेशन वेयर यू कैन ट्रैक योर क्रेडिट कार्ड एक्सपेंसेस. नाउ द यूथ यंग जनरेशन इज स्पेंडिंग सो मच मनी ऑन द क्रेडिट कार्ड थ्रू क्रेडिट कार्ड, बट जब बिल आते तब हम रियलाइज करते हैं कि दिस वॉज नॉट द नीड, ठीक है, ये एक डिजायर था, ये मेरी वॉन्ट थी, मेरी जरूरत नहीं थी, तो इतना मैंने खर्च कर दिया. बट इफ यू कैन कीप अ ट्रैक ऑफ ऑल योर एक्सपेंसेस एंड यू रिव्यू देम वीकली और मंथली बेसिस, ऑन मंथली बेसिस, देन यू अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाट वाज रिक्वायर्ड, व्हाट वाज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, व्हाट आई कुड हैव अवॉइडेड एंड हाउ आई कैन बेटर कीप अ ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड ऑफ माई एक्सपेंसेस. सो आई थिंक दिस शीट विल हेल्प यू ऑल. And once we are done with this webinar, you all will sit together with your spouse. See, one more thing I want to talk about is that in Indian culture, we do not have a system where we discuss financial aspects with our spouse. But in the last two eras, it has been seen that people don't discuss their financial things with their spouse. And unfortunately, when they lose their life, the spouse and the kids, they don't know पापा ने कहाँ का इन्वेस्ट कर रखा या उनके पास क्या क्या पॉलिसीज हैं या उनकी एफडी कहाँ कहाँ करा रखी है, उन्होंने कहाँ कहाँ अपना डीमैट अकाउंट खोल रखा है या शेयर्स हैं उनके पास या म्यूचुअल फंड है, फिर उसमें नॉमिनी है या नहीं है. तो बहुत सारे हैसल्स आप छोड़ के जाते हो जब आप जाते हो. तो यू यू द इमोशनल लॉस इज देयर विच इज विच यू कैन विच नो वन कैन सरपास, उसको तो हम कभी भी कंपनसेट कर ही नहीं सकते फाइनेंशियली. Then you leave a financial burden also. अगर किसी ने लोन ले रखा था और उसके अगेंस्ट में कोई सिक्योरिटी नहीं है और डेथ हो जाती है तो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द फैमिली मेंबर्स टू पे ऑफ दैट EMI. दूसरा ये है कि अगर आपने प्रॉपर इंश्योरेंस, एडिक्वेट इंश्योरेंस नहीं ले रखा है तो आपके फैमिली मेंबर्स को लॉस होता है. इफ यू डू नॉट हैव प्रॉपर इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, और इवन इफ यू आर हैविंग इन्वेस्टमेंट बट योर फैमिली मेंबर्स आर नॉट अवेयर ऑफ दोस इन्वेस्टमेंट, देन इट बिकम्स अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क. So what as a responsible citizen or a responsible person I should do? So if you're attending this webinar, that means you're serious about your investments, ठीक है, and you're looking for a way out. तो यहाँ पर मैं इसकी Excel आपके साथ share करूँगा. I would request everyone to share their mail IDs once again on the chat box, so I can mail you this sheet and you can use that. Then Sakshi has sent a message. We can convert permanent saving required for achieving our goals, and then based on the yes, exactly. So I'll share one more thing over here with everyone, that there is a rule which is called as 50-30-20 principle. It is a financial rule. Has anyone heard about this rule? किसी ने सुना है इसके बारे में? कहीं पढ़ा है? सुना है?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes, Sakshi. So can you just explain us what is this rule about 50-30-20? Or let me just summarize it because we are just on the verge of completing this. So suppose your income is 100 rupees. Then as per this rule, 50% of your income you should keep for your expenses, which are unavoidable. That means your household expenses or EMIs. Then 20% fund you should keep for your emergency. That means you should save 20% of the expenses. And now what remains is 30%. So 30% you should do investment. You should invest for your future. So this is a very small principle, but it is very effective, that if you are earning 100 rupees, then out of 100 rupees, 50%, 50 rupees aap kharchon ke liye rakh lijiye. 20 rupees jo baste hain aapke, wo aap emergency ke rakhiye. That means you should keep that intact in your bank account or any scheme which you can liquidate easily. And this is the important part, that 30% of your money you should invest for your future. ठीक है, एंड दिस इज अ थंब रूल. बट जनरली होता क्या है कि अगर मान लीजिए किसी का एक्सपेंस ही ज्यादा है, कोई बोलता है सर मैं 100 रुपीज अर्न करता हूँ एंड आई एम स्पेंडिंग ऑलमोस्ट 70-80 रुपीज, आई एम हार्डली लेफ्ट विद एनी सेविंग, देन व्हाट शुड आई डू इन दैट पर्टिकुलर केस? देन देर आर टू पॉसिबल आंसर्स टू इट. सो आई एम टेकिंग अ सिचुएशन वेयर सपोज समवन एक्सपेंस इज 80%, ही इज हैविंग सम लोन्स एंड ही इज लिविंग इन अ रेंटेड अपार्टमेंट एंड ही हैज हैविंग किड्स आल्सो एंड ही इज लाइक नॉट हिज इनकम वाइफ इज नॉट अर्निंग सो इट्स लाइक सिंगल इनकम एंड डबल एक्सपेंसेस सो इन दैट पर्टिकुलर केस व्हाट विल हैपन यू आर लेफ्ट विथ ओनली 20 rupees नाउ आउट ऑफ दैट 20 rupees आई मस्ट सी दैट 10% यू शुड सेव एंड 10% यू शुड इन्वेस्ट ठीक है इन्वेस्टमेंट इज नेसेसरी बहुत जरूरी है आपको इन्वेस्ट तो करना ही चाहिए एंड व्हाट आई मस्ट से इज दैट 80% को हम रिड्यूस करके इफ यू कैन रिड्यूस इट टू 70 or 60 देन वी कैन इंक्रीज दैट अमाउंट टू 15 or 20 सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो It is running into date format. Let me just. So this is basically a thumb rule, which says that if we have 100 rupees, then 50% you should keep for invest expenses, and whatever amount is left with, you can spend it out. Okay. Now again, some people might be looking at. The different options of investing like if I say that 30% you should invest then what are the various options that you can explore can anyone just guide us abhi aap log kaise invest kar rahe hain particularly I'll be sharing this sheet I'm just stopping the screen share for some time and now we are keeping a live interactive session where you can all participate and you can share your experiences about investments and tracking your finances how you have been tracking your finances and where you have invested your money so far so Manav says mutual fund and ppf yes so ppf is a good investment vehicle where you get a fixed rate of return and it is a guaranteed rate of return that you are getting 7% and whatever amount you get on maturity is totally tax free and you get a rebate in LIC also yes LIC now Has anyone heard about this word? I have written something. NPS is also a good option. HLB. आपने HLB सुना है इस सबने? No.
Yes.
Okay. So HLB is human life value. Life value. Sorry. So whenever we are buying any insurance, how do we buy insurance? So when we buy insurance, some agent approaches us or बोलते हैं sir एक policy ले लो ये अच्छी policy है इसका ये feature है ठीक है और हम लोग कभी भी initiate नहीं करते हैं process. So that is what I have seen generally. ठीक है कि हम कभी भी खुद से नहीं खरीदते insurance हमें बेचा जाता है और ऐसे ही बोल के बेचा जाता है कि यार ये तो policy कर दी किसी ने ठीक है और we might take a term insurance. Now the people are taking term insurance. But Let me ask you one question. Does term insurance has any value? Any life value? आपको maturity कोई होती है term insurance में? और अगर maturity होती है तो maturity पे कुछ sum assured मिलता है हमारे को कुछ पैसा मिलता है investment की value मिलती है जितना भी हम premium pay कर रहे हैं over the years. Do we get anything in return from that term insurance? And the answer is no. Then we should always consider look at From this point of view, if I'm taking a term insurance of 50 lakh rupees or 1 crore rupees, और मुझे लगता है कि हाँ आज मेरी age 30 है या 35 या 40 है, and I'm taking a term like term insurance of let's say next for 30 years or 40 years, that means my life, my risk, I am having a risk of 50 lakhs or 1 crore till age 70 or 75, and if something happens to me in between that term. My family will get the amount, a lump sum amount, good amount of money, and I'm hardly have to pay anything, 10,000 between 10,000 to 15,000 over the years. So, ये सोच के हम क्या करते हैं? हम एक term insurance ले लेते हैं, और हमें लगता है कि insurance का quota complete हो गया. हमें अब कोई और insurance buy करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, because I have a term plan. Great, बहुत सही सोच रहे हैं आप. लेकिन मेरा एक question है यहाँ पर सभी से. There are almost 8 to 10 participants in this meeting. So if I survive, if nothing happens to me, then what happens to the premium that I've paid to the company? एंड व्हाट डू आई गेट इन रिटर्न इफ नथिंग हैपेंस टू मी. यू कैन रिप्लाई इन द चैट बॉक्स नथिंग. सो इफ नथिंग हैपेंस टू यू दैट मींस यू गेट नथिंग. ठीक है. यस इट इज अ कॉस्ट ऑफ लाइफ. सो यू आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर getting any return out of that premium that you are paying. So many people when they buy insurance, वो क्या करते हैं, वो compare करते हैं उसको investment return से कि क्या percent return मिलेगा. ठीक है, तो term insurance में the return is zero. But if something happens to you, and when you compare the amount of premium that you have paid and the money that you are getting in return, that is uncomparable. आपने पूरे 30 years के tenure में कुछ 5-7 lakh रुपए की प्रीमियम भरी होगी और आपको 50 lakh रुपए मिल रहे. बट कॉन्ट्रेरी अगर अपन देखें और अगर हमको कुछ भी नहीं होता तो जो भी हमने प्रीमियम पे करी है उसका अमाउंट जीरो हो जाता है. वी डू नॉट गेट एनीथिंग इन रिटर्न. सो व्हाट आई वांट टू कन्वे हियर इज दैट कि अपार्ट फ्रॉम हैविंग अ टर्म इंश्योरेंस यू शुड ऑलवेज हैव सम पॉलिसीज व्हिच गिव्स यू सम मैच्योरिटी वैल्यू आल्सो एंड व्हिच कीप्स यू इंश्योर्ड. सो आई एम नॉट सेलिंग एनी इंश्योरेंस हियर. आई एम जस्ट selling a concept. I'm just guiding you on how you can design your financial life or your financial product wherein with term plan you are having some insurance which gives some amount on maturity. So whatever amount you are investing as a premium, that is giving you some return plus risk cover. Secondly, whatever amount is left, जो भी हमारा 30% की हम बात कर रहे थे उसे कैसे इन्वेस्ट करना चाहिए. तो मैनी पीपल आर सेइंग कि हम पीपीएफ में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं, म्यूचुअल फंड में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं, हम एनपीएस में डालते हैं. सो व्हाट शुड बी द रेशियो ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन ऑल दीज व्हीकल्स एंड हाउ यू शुड इन्वेस्ट. सो व्हाट एवर अमाउंट इज लेफ्ट विथ यू उसका 30-40% शुड बी इन्वेस्ट इन द सिक्योर्ड सिक्योरिटीज. लेट्स से एफडी और यू कैन से पीपीएफ और एनपीएस बिकॉज दीज आर सिक्योर्ड बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट बैक्ड है. बट जब हम एफडी की बात करते हैं तो एफडी में सिक्योरिटी कितनी है. कैन एनीवन टेल मी सपोज आई डू अ एफडी ऑफ 10 लाख इन द बैंक एंड नेक्स्ट डे द बैंक बिकम्स बैंकरप्ट, बैंक में चोरी हो जाती है लेट्स से. सो कैन आई क्लेम दैट 10 लाख रुपीस फ्रॉम द बैंक. मानव से 5 लाख. सो हाउ यू अराइव एट 5 लाख रुपीज. How come 5 lakh? Is it 50% of the amount invested? That is how you are calculating 5 lakh? Bank gives insurance for 5 lakh. Okay, so if someone has, okay, maximum guarantee given by government, that is RBI, is 5 lakh. So that means if someone has done a FD of 50 lakhs, then the bank is bound to give only 5 lakhs. Is it so? तो हम कैसे कह सकते हैं कि हमारा इन्वेस्टमेंट सिक्योर. दूसरा पॉइंट, सेकेंड पॉइंट, द बैंक एफडी इज गिविंग मी अ रिटर्न ऑफ 5% और मे बी लेस देन दैट. एंड व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट पोस्ट टैक्स रिटर्न्स, द रिटर्न इज आल्सो मिनिमाइज्ड टू द एक्सटेंट ऑफ द टैक्स दैट आई हैव टू पे बिकॉज़ द इंटरेस्ट इज बियरिंग सम टैक्स इंप्लिकेशन आल्सो. तो इज इट वाइजर टू इन्वेस्ट इन एफडीज इन नाउडेज बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट अ गुड ऑप्शन गेस बिकॉज यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द रिटर्न दैट कुड बीट इन्फ्लेशन. So FD is out of the box. So no one should do an FD with the bank. So what is the alternative? The good alternative is to invest in good company stock if you are a direct investor in stock market. But you should have a complete knowledge and you should be able to track your investment and you should have the potential to take that kind of risk. Then only you should go to that option. And if you are not able to track your investment or you manage your portfolio and you don't have that appetite for risk, then the next best option is mutual fund. Because mutual fund doesn't guarantee you any fixed interest, but over the years it has seen that the mutual fund had given almost double returns than your bank FDs or any other secured financial instrument. And mutual funds are governed by SEBI guidelines. So no company can do any this thing fault. So we can be sure of that. Then NPS is also a good option because NPS is ultimately investing in the stock market, but you have different options to choose from whether you want to go for an aggressive fund or a moderate fund or a conservative fund. We can select that. We can select the AMC also, okay, that company which is going to manage our investment. And the beauty about NPS is that the amount, whatever you are investing, you can withdraw only at the age 60. So what generally happens is when we invest any money and when we see the growth, तो हम क्या करते हैं पैसा निकाल लेते हैं. ऐसा होता है या नहीं होता? IPO में लगाया और डबल पैसा मिल रहा है, आप क्या करते हो? You sell that money, you sell the shares, those shares, and you take out that money and you spend that money somewhere else because that is what you have earned, isn't it? तो उससे कभी भी ऐसे करने से क्या वेल्थ क्रिएट हो सकती है? Can you accumulate a good amount of money over the years? And the answer is no. Balwant has given the answer no, and that is correct. So NPS is one vehicle which doesn't give you the chance to withdraw money. And when you're bound by something or some rules and regulation that you cannot withdraw money, either you will not put that money, or if you put that money, you will be rest assured that ye to mere retirement ka corpus hai aur ye mujhe retirement mein hi use mein lena hai. So whenever you are putting that money in NPS, you are sure that at 60 ka age, I'll be able to withdraw 60%. At 40%, I'll be able to buy an annuity. Okay. So that is also a good investment vehicle. When we talk about, and the most important thing that I wanted to convey as a message to all is that health insurance. Now, when I talk to people on insurance and when they are working, if someone dies, invested in, yes, exactly. So if someone dies, then the nominee will get the amount that is accumulated in NPS. The nominee will get the amount. That is the case in every instrument, that if something happens to the person who was investing in some instrument and he's not there, then definitely the nominee will get the amount. But you have to make sure that the nominee's name is registered. And now every institutions and every all the products have made it very necessary to have the KYC of the investor done and the nominee also. So without nominating anyone, you cannot do any investment. So that is already taken care of. Now I was talking about insurance. When you talk about health insurance, so generally kya hota hai ki I have an insurance policy to my employer and mera jo employer hai wo mujhe already risk cover de raha hai. Usne mera grip insurance kara rakha hai. Some of my salary goes to that particular part. So why should I take another health insurance? And why should I not put my money somewhere else and earn return on it? And why should I buy an insurance policy separately? So I have two opinions on it. Number one, first of all, when you look from the taxation point of view, you get a rebate, additional rebate, apart from your 1,50,000 in ATC. In ATD, you get up to 25,000. And if you invest for your senior citizen parents, then you get up to 50,000. So that is one aspect that you can save on taxes. Second thing, nowadays, because of COVID and because of uncertainty and because of growth aspects and prospects, people don't stick to a particular company over the years. Recently, there was a name in the news, Parag Agarwal. Have you heard about this name in the newspapers in the last 2-3 days? He's a person who belonged to, he's caught up and he's belonged to Ajmer, and he has been appointed as CEO of Twitter recently. So another Indian who has got on the news from India. And if you see his career profile, he has switched many jobs over the years. Bahut sari jobs unhone change kari hai. So whenever you switch any job, then all the benefits that you were getting from the previous company, they get stopped. So jo bhi aapne premium bhara hai, uska aapko koi benefit nahi milega. And if you're not working, unfortunately, suppose you're working in a company and then you realize ki I have to do my own business or I want to start up, then you do not have any insurance policy in that particular time. And when your age turns 40 or 40 plus, then the premium also increases. And secondly, you might get some diseases also, or you might put on some weight, and the insurance company may deny your policy or will charge you extra premium. So it is my opinion to everyone that apart from your company's insurance, you should have a separate medical policy which covers you, your wife and your kids. And then you can decide whenever a claim comes, you have two options. You can decide which policy, which amount, where the amount to take from. Either your employer can pay off, or you can claim the amount from your insurance company. and there is no capping also in this policy. So we are not discussing the health insurance, but this is one point that I wanted to highlight you. Now there is one question from Manav, and he says that I have mutual fund in my and my wife's name joint account. Can I make a minor as a nominee? So a minor cannot be an appointed as a nominee, but if you appoint a minor as a nominee, then you have to have a signee also. So if you are having a nominee, you are having your mutual fund in your name and your wife name as a joint holder, then you can nominate either your parent or maybe your wife parent, or if they are not there or they are of old age, then you cannot nominate your kids, because then you have to appoint an assignee for that. So generally it is seen that the husband has the nominee as a wife and wife has a nominee as a husband. So that is the normal tendency of the people over there. And that is the scene, aisa hi hota hai. But you can appoint someone from your family as a nominee, apart from your wife. But phir paisa unke paas jayega if both of you are not there. So if you don't mind that, then you can have, or if you want to appoint your minor, then you should have appoint a guardian for that case, in that case. Okay, so any other question anyone has? Okay, I would like to know how you got connected to this webinar, because I had shared the invite over so many platforms. So Manav and Balwant, can you just, and everyone can just reply in the chat box how you get connected. The information about this webinar, because now we will be doing the webinars on every Sunday on different topics. So I would like to have a feedback from all of you, and our team has noted down your mail ID. So we will mail the Excel sheet to you all today itself, so that you can sit back and work on your this thing. And whenever we do any next webinar, we'll share the links for the subsequent webinars also to you all. Okay, Manav, you want to say?
Yeah, hello.
Yeah.
Okay, in the Excel sheet you have shown, you have told to enter the, you know, how much is the invested and what is the current value.
Right.
So how we captured that in case of LIC, because now LIC will get matured after 60, I'll be getting the money.
Okay.
Right. How do I enter the, what is the current value? And same is the case with SIPs.
Okay. So let me answer the question first. What's LIC? So if you have taken a policy for, let's say, 20-30 years and it'll get matured at when you turn 60, then you know the maturity value of the policy at the age 60. You can enter that value. Or if you want to find out the exact value today, if you discontinue the policy, then you can ask LIC. You can go to any branch of LIC, or you can even go visit the LIC website, and you can find out the surrender value of that particular policy. So what happens is, when you buy an insurance policy, LIC keeps on adding some bonus to it every month, every year, and that policy has some value over the years. So you can find out, you can ask someone to give you the surrender value of the policy, and you can put that amount in the Excel sheet. But in case of LIC, since either you will get the amount on maturity or on death, so you cannot be sure of the amount that you are getting. Like, it will not be useful as such. But yes, if you want to find out the current value, you can take out the surrender value, and that is can be easily available. And if you want me to do it, you can share the details to me on my WhatsApp number. I'm just sharing my number in the chat box. You can send me the policy detail. I'll get back to you on the amount that you can get. Similar in case of SIPs. So may I know how you invested in SIP, like direct or regular investment you have done?
Direct mode.
Direct mode. So now there are two possibilities. If you've done through any apps, then the apps will show you the correct value. Secondly, you get a monthly statement from CAMS that is called CAS, Consolidated Account Statement. And on that CAS, you get the value of the investments and your whatever holding is there, you can do. Secondly, there is a new facility which has started by the AMFI. And that is a website that I'm sharing in the chat box. That is mfcentral.in.com. Sorry, you can visit this website and you can register yourself by putting your PAN number and your mobile number. And there also you can see all your investment at one place and the value. So that is also a way to track your SIP.
Okay. I have one more question.
Yes.
Like from retirement point of view, okay. I think Jeevan Umang is best one when it comes to retirement point of view.
Right.
So what is your view on that?
Okay. Jeevan Umang is a very good policy, I must say. And, it is basically a pension plan. So for the benefit of all, like everyone can listen to this because it is important. And I'll just tell you the features of Jeevan Umang. So it is a plan which covers the whole life. It is a whole life plan. That means you do not have any maturity. Your risk cover is till the till your death. So it gives you a whole life risk cover. And you can select from the term of 50, 20, 25 or 30. So you can... May I request everyone to be okay. So, Jeevan Umang is a policy which is a pension plan. So, you can take a term of 15 years or 20 years or 25 years, 30 years. So, let us take an example. Someone is 30 years old and he's taking a policy of 15 years. So, he'll pay the premium for next 15 years till the age 45. And after he turns 46, from 46 years till he's alive, he starts getting the premium back, the amount back as a what he has paid as a premium. And that is a guaranteed 8% that is get on the sum assured. So suppose someone is taking a policy of 10 lakhs, then he gets 80,000 every year from the end of the tenure of the policy. If the tenure is 15 years, then from 16 years onwards, till he's alive, he gets every year, he starts getting 80,000. And the sum assured also keeps on increasing every year. So you have taken a policy of 10 lakhs, LIC keeps on adding the bonus, and that amount grows to almost say 40 to 50,000 after 15, 20 years. And whenever you are no more, the nominee will get a good amount or a lump sum amount on maturity. So this is how a Jeevan Umang works.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Okay, any other question, if someone wants to talk on anything or they have any doubt and they want to clear, we can have some few questions also before the session.
Yeah, just one more question. Like I have some policies of LIC in the past. Okay. So like after paying premium for 10 years or 12 years, like is a wise decision to surrender those policies? Like that depends upon policy to policy, or how can that be done?
See, first of all, that you need to check out the policy you have taken, how many years to pay the amount, and what is the maturity benefit that you are getting. So there cannot be any thumb rule or one way decision for each policy. It is has to be a customized decision based on the details of the policy that you have taken. So you should consult someone or an advisor, or I can help you out of this session. You can reach out to me personally for this, but you should not take a universal decision on your LIC policies. It is a customized thing, and every policy you have to check out, like what is the amount of premium that you have paid. If you surrendered today, what value are you getting? If you're getting very less, then it is better to continue. But if you think that if I pay so much of premium and what I'm not getting anything, a good amount and maturity, and the risk score is also not that great, then you might think of discontinuing this policy and reinvest the amount which you are investing in this particular policy to some other policy. So that decision you can take based on the details of each policy. Okay. So thank you all for joining this session, and I hope you all, it was a useful session for everyone, and I could do justice with your Sunday time that you had given to me, because Sunday everyone would like to relax and enjoy, but you all had taken out time and joined this session. So I believe that you find this session useful to you. And definitely, once you get the sheet and when you start filling your information, that would help you in planning your finances well and organizing your finances well. And we have noted your details. Yes, Banan. Okay. So thank you all for joining in. And we have noted down your details. Someone, Manan, you want to add something?
No, I already asked a question. Okay, thank you.
Okay. So thank you a lot, everyone, for joining in. And next Sunday also, we'll come up with some more sessions on some interesting topics like this. And I'll share that Excel sheet with all of you on your mail ID. So thanks for joining in. Thank you.